Hello children, as we have already started chapter number 5, the fundamental unit of life. So now we are going to learn the structure of compound microscope. I am here with some PowerPoint presentation. See, this is the figure 5.1 compound microscope. It is present on page number 57. So children, cells are too small to be seen by the naked eyes, and for that is the reason why we use the compound microscope to observe the cells. So microscope are high resolution instrument that we can utilize to observe this microscopic very small objectives. So many types of microscopes are there, including compound microscope, compound light microscope, then electron microscope. So each and every microscope has its own specialty. Like compound microscope can magnify the range of that particular specimen by 10 times to 100 times than its original image or the original size. Light microscope can magnify the image in the range of 10 to 1500 times more. Also, electronic microscope can magnify the range in magnify the image in the range of 1 lakh to 5 lakh times more. Then you can see here two microscopes are given. First the first diagram is of common compound microscope, which we are having in our biology lab also. Again, second is compound light microscope. So this compound light microscope, there is a very small difference is present in between these two structures. So these two microscopes are mainly differ in the source of light they use. In case of first diagram, which is a common compound microscope, the mirror is get utilized to cover the light, cover the sunlight. And instead of mirror, in that compound light microscope, illuminators get utilized at the base. We will see the detail in next slides. So first of all, what is compound microscope? A compound microscope is an instrument that is used to view the magnified images of small objects of glass on the glass slide. So it can be achieved higher level of magnification. The characteristics, the main characteristics of a compound microscopes are two or more convex lenses can be present. Typical magnification range is in between 40x to 1000x. One objective is used at a time. Two dimensional images are available in monocular, binocular and trinocular configuration. So what is the meaning of monocular, binocular and trinocular? So monocular, the diagram you can see here, it is a monocular. Monocular means it is having only one eyepiece. Now in this diagram you can see that this microscope is having two eyepiece. At the top you can see the two eyepieces. Then in next diagram you can see three eyepieces. So in that way, the number of eyepieces, it based upon the number of eyepieces that particular microscope is having. Monocular is only with one eyepiece, then binocular is with two eyepieces, and trinocular is with three eyepieces. So next is what exactly it is. The term compound refers to the microscope having more than one lens. The term light refers to the method by which light transmit the image to your eye. Microscope is a combination of two words, micro meaning small and scope meaning the view. So different parts and the functions. The eyepiece is a lens through which viewers looks to see the specimen. It is usually contained 10x or 15x power lenses. In biology laboratory we are having the 10x eyepiece. The body tube always connect the eyepiece to the objective lens. Then in case of objective lenses and stage clips, objective lenses are one of the most important part of the compound microscope, and they are very close to specimen. A standard microscope has a three to four objective lenses. The microscopes that are present in our biology lab, they are having three objective lenses. For one is of 10x resolution, second is of 40 or 45x, and third one is of 100x. Stage clips are the metal clips that held the slide in a space. So arm and base, the arm connect the body tube to the base of the microscope, whereas the base support the microscope, and it also have the illuminator in case of compound light microscope, and in case of our simple microscope it also hold the mirror. Then illuminator and stage, as I told you before, illuminator is present in the compound light microscope, whereas in our common microscope it is a mirror. So illuminator is a light source of the microscope which is present at the base. A compound light microscope is used low voltage bulb as an illuminator. So stage is a flat platform where the slide we can place. Nose piece and aperture. So nose piece is the rotating turret that hold the objective lenses. The microscopes that we are having, it contained that nose piece contain three objective lenses. It is of 10x, 45x and 100x, as I told you before. The viewer spins the nose piece to select the different objective lenses. The aperture is the middle of the stage that allows the light from the illuminator to reach towards the specimen. Then condenser and diaphragm. Condenser and diaphragm both are present at the base of the microscope. This condenser helps. It is used to collect and focus the light from mirror or illuminator on the specimen, whereas the work of diaphragm is diaphragm is a 5-hole disc placed under the stage, and each hole is of different diameter. By turning it, we can vary the amount of light which is passing through the stage opening. Okay, so everything that condenser, diaphragm, objective lenses, eyepiece, whatever we are using, it is just to focus and to capture the image of that particular specimen very keenly. Okay, so this is the diagram showing compound light microscope. Then total magnification in case of 4x scanning objective, 10x eyepiece we can use. In case of 10x objective, we can use 10x eyepiece. Again, 40x objective also we can utilize 10x eyepiece. Then use of compound microscope. The compound microscope is of great use in pathology labs so as to identify the different disease causing agents. In forensic laboratories also, compound light microscopes are used to identify the presence of mineral and metals in the human cell so as to solve the criminal cases. So forensic experts can also find out the origin of drug by viewing its component particles under the microscope. Along with that, students in the school and colleges are benefited by the use of microscope for conducting their academic experiments. It is of immense help as the students can now see the bacteria and also viruses. So viruses we cannot observe under compound light microscope or any other microscope, children. Viruses we can observe only under electronic microscopes, and all institutes cannot be facilitated with electronic microscopes because electronic microscopes are too costly. So the government funded research laboratories like Central Drug Research Institute, Lucknow, CDRI, then NIRI in Pune, NIRI in Nagpur, CCMB in Hyderabad. These institutes are the government funded research institutes, and only these institutes are having the facility of electronic microscope. So plant cells and also the microorganisms living on them can also observe under the microscope. So a compound microscope has proved the beneficial to the biologist. So these are few images. First image is of blood cell, second is of human cell, and third is of plant cell. So thank you.